Welcome to the show. I'm Jen. My guest today is Ari Levin, Executive Director of the Madison Center for the Arts. Good morning.
Good morning,
Jen. How are you?
I'm fantastic.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
We're really lucky to have you in this community with all of your background and skills and expertise. So I'm excited to share that with everyone who may not know what the Madison is and what you're going to be doing there. So I want to jump right into your background and how that translates into your current role. So you actually attended Arizona State University, which shout out to the Sun Devils. We love that. And then you went on a journey that took you to some really special places to work with some really exceptional people. And so I'll start out by saying that you're one of only a handful of Americans to play the title role of Hamlet, as well as produce and direct national tours with members of the Royal Shakespeare Company in England.
That is correct.
Wow. Yes. That's pretty awesome.
It was definitely like a dream come true.
So you graduated college and you leave and go to England?
Pretty much so, yes. After I graduated ASU, I spent some time, I was in LA and Vegas kind of going back and forth. And then everything was bent for England,
yeah,
as we say.
So that's, I mean, Shakespeare was kind of your
passion.
Okay.
100%.
So to end up there, that's the ultimate, I would think.
100%. There's nowhere, you can't experience really Shakespeare until you're in England, mm-hmm, and seeing where, you know, like going to Wales where Henry V was and going to all these places that you can't, even though you can read it in a book, I feel like you can't actually experience it and play it to its full potential without being there. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're like touching and feeling all of the culture and history firsthand.
Right, and so, it's very important.
So you got to perform, and you got to work with other performers, and how long were you there?
Just a year.
Okay, and then you obviously came back to the United States?
I did, yes. So from there, I got asked to direct Star Trek. So
wow, that seems like a diversion from Shakespeare a little bit.
Yes, no. If you know the new generation, Patrick Stewart, of course, Sir Patrick Stewart from the Royal Shakespeare, yeah, Company. So there was definitely a Shakespeare,
okay,
connection there for sure. So came back to Vegas, which I never thought I would do, but did. Mm-hmm. And directed Star Trek The Experience there, and then wound up forming my own production company and producing and directing several shows on the Las Vegas Strip, including having my own show that ran for over 6 years on the,
wow,
Las Vegas Strip.
That's phenomenal. Congratulations.
So, that was fun.
That's why I say we're so lucky to have you here with everything that you've done. So a little bit more of the evolution, and then I want to get to why Arizona and what brings you here now.
Sure. So then after kind of directing and producing shows on the Strip and some television stuff here and there, I actually got a call from one of the executive producers of Oprah and got asked to produce and direct episodes for her. So
that's another ultimate.
Yeah, it was. And I directed one episode and she loved it so much, she put me under contract for 4 years. So
wow,
was really with her right before I came back here.
And so what courted you here?
It was a combination of things. I mean, one, it was the opportunity to take artistic and executive control over this beautiful, brand new, you know, $24 million theater and create a full season that had never been done.
Mm-hmm.
So that was one, definitely. And then things in Vegas were changing. And then with, of course, the pandemic shutting everything down. And my contract with Oprah was up. So it was kind of, okay, here it is.
And what a great opportunity. I mean, the theater being new and you get to really create what you want it to be. And also a little bit back to the theater,
right,
aspect too, which
are my roots.
A little bit more your passion. Yeah.
Right.
So what do you envision bringing to the community at the Madison?
I want to bring a whole diverse type of programmatic culture that has never been here before.
So is it families? Is it adult? Is it everybody?
It's everybody.
What kind of, you're going to bring a wide array of shows that appeal to the masses.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
And some that are going to be unique to coming to Arizona or off Broadway, or how does that translate?
For sure. So actually, it's more Broadway, and we're bringing a whole series of shows that have never been to the state of Arizona or to Phoenix.
So people will be able to buy season tickets and
yes.
go to one-off shows. And then will the venue be used for other things as well that the community can get involved and engage or support?
Absolutely. We just formed a partnership with Arizona State University with the entire music department. They're
wow.
going to do a whole series of concerts and free performances for the Madison School District as well as for the public.
So I should probably back up a little bit. Give us some, you mentioned $24 million, you know, venue. Give us some nuggets and facts about the state-of-the-art facility that it is.
So it is. It's basically a brand new performing arts center. It's been here like 2 years, but this is the first professional season. It's state-of-the-art LED lighting and one of the best sound systems in the entire state. It's 900 seat.
Wow.
Like I said, they spent like $24 million on it. It has a full parking garage, so parking's not an issue. And a very large sprung stage for all types of dance recitals and everything else.
And it's got a great location. I mean, we love downtown Phoenix, but it's in Phoenix, a little bit outside of that downtown area, so a little more accessible off the 51, 16th Street in Missouri.
Yep, correct. Right off Camelback
yeah.
and 16th Street. Right.
That's great.
So very, very central.
Well, when I hear Madison, it resonates for me because yep. growing up here, I went to the Madison School District, so there
right.
is a tie with the Madison schools.
Correct, 100%. So every dime that's raised from the Performing Arts Center goes back into the Madison School District.
Wow.
So 100% of all the profits and proceeds all go to the Madison School District.
That's great. Well, okay. my two alumni were just mentioned, my K through 8th and my ASU.
Right.
So I love all the tie-ins. Well, I'm really excited for what you're bringing to the community with your background and to the Madison. So I'm really excited for the season, and everyone should get season tickets and, you know, get involved in supporting the arts in our community too. So thank you.
Thank you for
having
me.
We'll have you
Jay.
Back to talk about more of the shows as well.
Please, anytime. Thank you so much.
Thank you. We'll see you next time on Now with Jen.